Because everybody wants you.
Yeah, it's a very difficult process, and it's also inclusive of a whole lot of guilt. Guilt for having to say no, there aren't enough hours in the day, and living in Alaska, it's a long trip to get outside of Alaska and attend these events. So I have some guilt involved in this, but as many of these events that I can attend, I will. My family has
and
to come
do.
First. And my kids and their activities are going to come first. So right. Summertime, when they're out of school, we'll be able to do a lot more traveling. But events that have to do with allowing a more welcoming world for special needs children and members of families, I want to be involved in those events. Events that promote protection of our Constitution and our rights, especially our Second Amendment rights, our First Amendment rights, too.
Right.
Common sense conservative principles that are highlighted at an event. I want to be a part of that, too. Girls' sports. I want to encourage girls to get out there and engage in healthy competition and physical activity. So I want to get more plugged into that aspect of our culture, too. So many things that I want to do. I just am always praying for more hours in the day.
You don't have a shortage of people and places to go, that's for sure. I'm wondering if OP, I've got this Sarah Palin radio listener, OP Ditch. I believe that you know him, Governor. He's with Veterans for Sarah. OP, what's your question for Governor Palin?
Hey, am I on?
Yes, you are.
All right. Hi, LaDonna. Nice
hey, what's
to
what's your question
nice
for Governor Palin?
Hey, Governor Palin, it's a real pleasure to talk to you tonight.
Thank you so much.
I had an opportunity to talk to your dad a few months back on the radio like this. But, you know, there are a lot of veterans out there who are part of this Tea Party thing. But right now we're interested in what's happened with Track. And we want to know how he's doing and what he's about. I think you mentioned him the other night on the Glenn Beck show. And tell us about that tattoo.
I love you for asking about my son. Thank you. And, yeah, I mentioned him on the Glenn Beck show. I don't know if he knows that yet because he never seeks the spotlight. But he had just gotten a tattoo of the Statue of Liberty on his arm. So I thought, oh, how ironic and timely. Here we are. We're talking about the Statue of Liberty, and I'd just been asking, well, what does this mean, son, to you on your arm? And he knew all about it, so he educated me. But Track finished up his year in Iraq with his Striker Brigade in the United States Army and stationed in Fairbanks, Alaska right now, and he's got a lot of good things in his future because he made the right decision in seeking to serve something greater than self, just like you did, sir, and all of our fellow past and present and the future young men and women of this country who are making the right decision to want to get out there and serve this country and protect our freedoms, and I just love you, veterans, so thank you.
Hey, thanks for calling in, OP.
Okay, thank you, LaDonna. Appreciate it.
Governor Palin, I want to ask you, why do you think the entrenched political establishment of the Republican Party in Washington are not welcoming you with open arms, considering your huge popularity and for saving McCain from losing even more than he did?
Well, I thank you for that compliment, for the kudos in that question, but LaDonna, my answer to that is the same answer that I gave you as to why kind of the elite establishment overall may not accept someone like me. It does have to do, it applies, unfortunately, to some GOPers who, if you're not their chosen one, they're going to make life kind of difficult for you, which is fine. It's good. It makes you work harder. It makes you have to prove yourself. And I'm kind of used to an underdog status and the things that I've done, especially politically, all these years, used to it. It makes me work that much harder.
I understand that. I understand that totally. Hey, I was going to ask you real quick. How is the young woman from Alaska who was seriously injured in the Haitian earthquake? How's she doing?
I hear that she's doing better. I'm going to call a couple reporters this afternoon and find out because I was just reading about her. But kind of shows us how small the world is, isn't it? That you're going to find that everybody somehow, some way is affected by the Haitian tragedy, and I think it allows Americans especially to get out there and do all that we can to help those who are so hurting today in Haiti, and that includes contributing financially through the Red Cross and Salvation Army, other credible groups that can help.
thank you, Governor, for coming on, and thank you and your whole family for all the sacrifices, for contributing to making our country even better. We thank you. You're listening to Sarah Palin Radio on WSRadio.com.